evening, everybody. Welcome to our Eucharist on Tuesday evening. Today, the church is commemorating this man here, Saint Jean-Baptiste Vianney. He's often known as the curé d'Ars, which basically means the curate of a place called Ars in France. And he's a rather lovely, down-to-earth saint that we're commemorating today in our service. So as usual, please join in with the words in yellow as they come up on the screen. Paul's giving me the thumbs up so that I know that you can all hear me. We always have to double check ever since that first time when none of you could hear what I was saying. So let's begin our service. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we come to confess our sins together. So we take a moment to consider where we might have got it wrong with the people that we live with. Maybe something we've said at work, or maybe we've just ignored God all week. And we come to confess together that we've got it wrong. We have not always worshipped God, our Creator. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We have not always followed Christ, our Saviour. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. We have not always trusted in the Spirit, our guide. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So, let me pray the collect for today. Let us pray. Eternal God, you called Saint Jean Vianney to proclaim your glory in a life of prayer and pastoral zeal. Keep the leaders of your church faithful and bless your people through their ministry, that the church may grow into the full stature of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. A reading from the prophecy of Malachi. My covenant with Levi was a covenant of life and well-being, which I gave him. This called for reverence, and he revered me and stood in awe of my name. True instruction was in his mouth, and no wrong was found on his lips. He walked with me in integrity and uprightness, and he turned many from iniquity. For the lips of a priest should guard knowledge, and people should seek instruction from his mouth, for he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Feed my lambs. A second time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Tend my sheep. He said to him the third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter felt hurt because he had said to him the third time, Do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Feed my sheep. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. May I speak in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Jean-Marie Baptiste Vianney was born in Dardilly, near Lyon, in 1786. The son of a farmer, he spent much of his childhood working as a shepherd on his father's farm. He had little formal education, but at the age of 20 he began studying for the priesthood, which he found extremely difficult. Despite his poor academic performance, he was ordained in 1815, mainly because of his devotion and holiness. He served as assistant priest at Écully, and in 1818 was appointed curé, or parish priest, of the remote, unimportant village of Ars-en-Dombes. From this backwater, his fame was to spread worldwide. His skills in preaching and spiritual counsel earned him a reputation as a discerning and wise priest. His visiting penitents soon numbered 300 a day. I've got no idea how he could have got 300 confessions a day. He would preach to 11 o'clock each morning and then spend up to 16 hours in the confessional. A Franciscan tertiary who reflected the spirituality of Francis, Vianney's compassion and understanding of human weakness often brought him to tears. His love of God and his people ensured that he remained in Ars the rest of his life.
Can you aim to turn the microphone?
Despite a call.
Sorry.
Is it loud enough?
A few people have said it's not loud enough.
Ah. Let me try again. Okay. Apparently some of you couldn't hear me very well, so I've just turned the microphone up. Sorry about that, everybody. Hopefully it sounds a bit louder now and I'll speak up. So his skills in preaching and spiritual counsel earned him a reputation as a discerning and wise priest. His visiting penitents soon numbered 300 a day, and he would preach at 11 o'clock each morning and then spend up to 16 hours in the confessional. A Franciscan tertiary who reflected the spirituality of Francis, Vianney's compassion and understanding of human weakness often brought him to tears. His love of God and his people ensured that he remained in Ars the rest of his life, despite a call to the religious life and many offers of promotion in the church. He died on this day in the year 1859. So he's a very likeable saint, is Jean-Baptiste Vianney. Pretty uneducated, he really struggled at theological college, and I've known some of the best priests I've known have been the ones that weren't particularly academic but just had a true pastoral heart. And sorry, just trying to fiddle around with the microphone. I don't know why it's there's a problem with it today. It's the same setting as usual. Okay, well, we'll carry on. I'll just have to plough ahead, I'm afraid. Okay, so as I was saying, he was a very humble priest and beloved, and that's what made him famous. There is a lovely story about him, that he once went into one of his chapels and saw an elderly farmer staring at the Blessed Sacrament that was on the high altar. And Jean Vianney said, Jean Vianney said to this farmer, what are you doing? And the farmer said, I look at him and he looks at me. And so he was talking about contemplating God. And that's become a famous story, really, to describe what contemplative prayer is like. That we can just sit. And fortunately, now we're starting to reopen our churches. There is something special about sitting in a church and contemplating God. But we can also, as we've been learning, do that at home as well. So you might find, I find contemplative prayer quite difficult because I'm too much, oh, there's a squirrel. But other people find contemplative prayer the best way to connect with God, just sitting in silence and contemplating God as God looks with love on us. So we have that beautiful image of a simplicity of faith from Jean-Baptiste Vianney today. So let us come to a time of prayer. Oh, and there's a picture of him, sorry, I forgot to show you that one earlier, an icon. So in peace, let us pray to Jesus our Lord, who ever lives to make intercession for us. Saviour of the world, be present in all places of suffering, violence and pain, and bring hope even in the darkest night. We pray especially for the people of Lebanon and Beirut after the terrible explosion that happened there today. Inspire us to continue your work of reconciliation today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of the Church, empower by your Spirit all Christian people and the work of your Church in every land. We pray for all churches as they begin to reopen and welcome people back into their buildings. We pray for continued safety. Give us grace to proclaim the gospel joyfully in word and deed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Shepherd and guardian of our souls, guide and enable all who lead and serve this community and those on whom we depend for our daily needs. Grant that we may seek the peace and welfare of this place. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Great physician, stretch out your hands to bring comfort, wholeness and peace to all who suffer in body, mind or spirit. And we bring before God now our dear friend David Hull. And we pray for anyone else that we know who is in need of our prayers at this time. Fill us with compassion, that we may be channels of your healing love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Conqueror of death, remember for good those whom we love but see no longer. Help us to live this day in the sure and certain hope of your eternal victory. We remember especially today those who've recently died. Pam Rundle, John Wybrow, and Thomas Edward North. Let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you. So let's offer one another a sign of virtual peace in the way that we usually do now. We're getting used to this now. So either write peace be with you in the comments or give us a thumbs up and share the peace with those that you're with. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Hopefully you can all hear me now okay. Sorry about the sound problems earlier. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Saviour. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death, and so we gladly thank you with saints and angels praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine again. He praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. James, St. John the Baptist, St. Jean Vianney and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. So we pray for the coming of the kingdom in the words our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. The body of Christ broken for us, keep us in eternal life. Amen. And the blood of Christ shed for us, keep us in eternal life. Amen. Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits you have given me, for all the pains and insults you have borne for me. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may I know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen. So we pray together. Lord, in these days of mercy, make us quiet and prayerful. In these days of challenge, make us stronger in you. In these days of emptiness, take possession of us. In these days of waiting, open our hearts to the mystery of your cross. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let's bow our heads to receive God's blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Thank you for coming this evening. Just to say that we have our next service in church. This coming Sunday will be at Bulbrough at 10 o'clock. And also just a quick reminder that actually from this weekend, the wearing of face coverings in church will be mandatory. It was before it was recommended, now it's mandatory unless you have a health reason why you can't wear a mask. So don't forget to bring them on Sunday if you join us. If you don't feel quite safe to come back into church yet, you can watch the service either live at 10 o'clock on the St James Facebook page, or alternatively you might want to wait until the evening so that you can watch the service on YouTube and the words of the service will come up on the screen for you to join in. So hopefully I'll see some of you on Sunday at Bulbrough at 10 o'clock. See you next time. Bye. I can never do this smoothly.